In patients with heart failure, cardiac remodeling is associated with poor prognosis, whereas reversal of remodeling is associated with improved outcomes. Therefore, medicines that can help prevent the development of cardiac remodeling is critical to slow or even reverse the progression of the disease. In this video, we are going to look at several medications and how they can reverse heart failure. Before we begin, remember to hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up if you're ready to explore with us. All right, let's get started. Number 1, beta blockers. Beta blockers have been shown to inhibit adverse remodeling by reducing catecholamine release and attenuating the neurohormonal cascade that leads to remodeling. Here's how it works. One of the earliest responses to a decline in cardiac output in chronic heart failure is sympathetic activation, which raises catecholamine levels. Elevated catecholamines have numerous adverse effects that lead to cardiac remodeling. Other effects of sympathetic activation include an increased heart rate, enhanced force of contraction, and a faster rate of conduction. Beta blockers increase heart rate variability by rebalancing the sympathovagal axis. The adverse effects of elevated catecholamines can also be counteracted by beta blockers. Research shows that beta blockers increase left ventricular ejection fraction, decrease end-systolic volume, and improve ventricular filling time, thereby reducing remodeling in chronic heart failure, CHF. In patients with chronic heart failure, increased heart rate due to sympathetic activation is associated with poor prognosis. Major trials of beta blockers in chronic heart failure showed a consistent 35% reduction in mortality associated with a 10 to 15 BPM reduction in heart rate. In addition, beta blockers are believed to have direct antiarrhythmic effects that protect against sudden cardiac death. Number 2, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors, ACEIs, and angiotensin receptor blockers, ARBs. Angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors are medications that reduce blood pressure by relaxing veins and arteries. Studies found that angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors also play a role in prevent cardiac remodeling. How angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors work in our bodies is fairly simple. At the cellular level, angiotensin II promotes fibrosis and collagen deposition, leading to cardiac myocyte hypertrophy and interstitial fibrotic changes in cardiac fibroblasts. These changes are associated with left ventricular hypertrophy, a stiff ventricle, and progressive left ventricular dysfunction, ultimately resulting in cardiac remodeling and congestive heart failure. Angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors reduce the production of angiotensin II by blocking the angiotensin-converting enzyme, which converts angiotensin I into angiotensin II. By reducing the concentration of angiotensin II in the blood and in local tissues, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors inhibit myocyte hypertrophy, prevent the fibrosis and collagen deposition, and enhance the contractile function of myocytes. Additionally, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors are known to increase the accumulation of bradykinin in tissues. This increased bradykinin activation may help to attenuate structural remodeling in the infarcted heart. Angiotensin receptor blockers, ARBs, represent another medication with comparable effects in the treatment of heart failure. Angiotensin I receptors, AT1RS, present in various tissues including the heart, serve as the action sites for angiotensin II. These receptors activate intracellular signaling pathways that lead to hypertension, endothelial dysfunction, and cardiac remodeling. Angiotensin receptor blockers mitigate these effects by competitively displacing angiotensin II from the AT1 receptors, thereby reducing cardiac remodeling. Furthermore, angiotensin receptor blockers antagonize angiotensin II-induced vasoconstriction, aldosterone release, and catecholamine release. This leads to a reduction in blood pressure, which plays an important role in preventing the hemodynamic stress that is responsible for the development of cardiac remodeling. Number 3, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists. Mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists, MRAs, also known as aldosterone receptor antagonists, are a class of drugs that block the effects of aldosterone, inhibiting sodium reabsorption and promoting water loss. This can lead to lower blood pressure and fluid accumulation around the heart. Aldosterone, the primary mineralocorticoid hormone in the body, is produced in the adrenal cortex of the adrenal glands. It enhances sodium reabsorption by the kidneys, salivary glands, sweat glands, and colon while promoting the excretion of hydrogen and potassium ions. Aldosterone activates mineralocorticoid receptors, MRs, in the heart and blood vessels, functioning as a lock and key. Many of the beneficial effects of mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists in heart disease are independent of changes in blood pressure. Activation of mineralocorticoid receptors in the heart and blood vessels has been shown to trigger several pathological effects, including excessive extracellular matrix accumulation, leading to cardiac fibrosis, oxidative stress, which is an imbalance of free radicals and antioxidants causing cell damage, and persistent inflammation. Elevated inflammation levels in the body have been linked to increased plaque buildup in the arteries. The antifibrotic, antioxidative, and anti-inflammatory effects of mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists are beneficial in combating cardiac remodeling, hypertrophy, and dysfunction in various disease conditions. Mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists, MRAs, are of two types: steroidal and non-steroidal compounds. Steroidal MRAs, spironolactone and eplerenone, were initially developed for the treatment of primary aldosteronism, hypertension, and later heart failure. Adding spironolactone to an ACEI has been shown to reduce mortality by 30%. To improve the safety profile of MRAs, researchers have developed several non-steroidal MRAs, such as finerenone, esaxerenone, and apeirenone. Finerenone was approved for use by the FDA in July 2021. Well, these three main medications not only relieve the symptoms of heart failure, but have also been shown to potentially reverse the disease. It's important to note that the treatment of heart failure patients with reduced ejection fraction involves a combination of established medications and newly developed, innovative pharmacological therapies. In our next video, we'll take a closer look at these newly developed pharmacological therapies. Stay tuned for more information. This is the second video about heart failure can be reversed. If you are interested, you can also watch the first part on this channel. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to leave them below. If you found this video helpful, we'd appreciate it if you could like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.